Members of the Philippine men's basketball team are back to their day jobs, competing against each other in the PBA. But they will soon be called again to represent the country for the continuation of the FIBA World Cup qualifiers. And here with us in the studio is the head coach, the man himself of Team Pilipinas, multi-titled PBA coach, Yeng Guiao. Coach Yeng, it is an honor for you to be here on the show.
No, it's my honor. Thank you for having me.
Maraming salamat, Coach Yeng. Coach Yeng, we'll date back, of course, to the preparations for the Asian Games, to the FIBA World Cup qualifiers. I guess this is the first live interview that we've had. Coach Yeng, so your quick assessment of those two tournaments for your team?
Well, it was a whirlwind preparations. Actually, we thought it wasn't pushing through. You know, there was a time the SBP decided to just let it go and concentrate on some other matters. No? But due to the public clamor, SBP gave in, and then the PBA supported the whole effort. And then rain or shine made that sacrifice of offering the team or the core of it. And rain or shine made the request that I coach the team. No? So that's the whole story behind our participation in the Asian Games. But the main problem then was the lack of time. No? I think we only had a week or so. Then when we flew to Jakarta, Indonesia, suerte. No? There was an effort to bring in Jordan Clarkson, and things just fell into place. And when we were there, he arrived, and then we had about 2 or 3 days practice with him. Then we were already playing. So time was really the most important issue when you want to blend the team, when you want to put in a system. You really need at least 4 to 6 weeks, no, at least. But we had to do that in about a week's time. And I'm just thankful for the effort of the guys, for their dedication, for their sacrifice. If not for that attitude, I don't think we would have been successful.
What was the silver lining in the amount of, very little amount of preparation time?
The silver lining was the commitment, no, of the guys. No, that people thought that these highly paid PBA players are not going to commit to a national team and are going to be soft and are going to be just complacent. No, but no. They did their best. They brought everything on the floor, and they just played their hearts out. And people saw that. No, naramdaman ng tao yon. No, the players were bleeding in losing teeth, and they had to sacrifice family time, but they were there. They enjoyed it. Actually, we all enjoyed it, and there was a bond that was created, no, among all of us. And I think that bond was really something that really energized us and just brought the team together.
Gallant stand in the Asian Games, though. Yes. Hindi tayo nakapasok sa Final Four, that is okay. But then at the same time, that was a better finish compared to the previous Asian Games. That was the stint where Jordan Clarkson was in for you guys. Coach Yeng, ano po yung pinaka natutunan ng players? And you also, as coaching staff, with Jordan came in.
Well, when Jordan came in, you know, as a coach, you kind of feel him out. Pakiramdaman mo muna kung anong klaseng attitude ba siya. But you know, he was a real person. Totoong tao siya. His feet were on the ground. He was very coachable. His teammates liked him, and he liked his teammates. And he adapted to the system really well because he's intelligent. He's a high IQ player. And I think he struggled a little bit in the beginning. But after our first game, he got to know the players a little better. He got to understand the system a little better. And he was playing with a little bit more loosely. And his talent was really showing at that time.
Coach Yeng, yung experience in the Asian Games, and then you also had little time, relatively, to prepare for the FIBA World Cup qualifiers against Iran. So how was that like, you know, coming in to that preparation time?
Actually, same problem, because we had to change some players. So when you change 4 or 5 players, you start over again. And again, time was of the essence, and it was a very short time to prepare. We had to fly to Iran. and then prepare in a hostile environment when you're playing away from home. And then you had to play a very strong team that's played siguro at least 10 years. No, kasi I was in a coach of the national team also in 2009.
And sila yon.
The core of that team in 2009 was already there. Imagine 2009 ngayon kalaban mo sila pa rin. No, how strong and how solid that team is, no? So, although of course they're a little older, but even if they're a little older, they're still actually fit. We were actually expecting that Haddadi would play, but he did not play. He played only for a few seconds, but we prepared the whole game plan around him. No? So maybe, baka ano pa rin yun, no? Baka nakabuti pa sa kanila yun,
yes, yes,
in a way.
Yes, a days later after that Iran game, you had to go home to the Philippines, Araneta Coliseum, closed door.
Yes.
How was that like against Qatar?
It's weird. It's parang bizarre.
Parang tune-up game nga, coach, yung
parang
ano eh,
tune-up game. Pero parang ang lungkot, ha? National team to, tapos kalaban mo, foreign team. And then the only people cheering for you were your bench, your people on the bench, no? And in the first half, we struggled. No? We struggled. Our shots wouldn't go in, and then their three-point shooting was in sync. Sila yung, ano, sila yung magandang shooting. So, halftime, we just gathered ourselves together again and told ourselves we have to play defense. No? And from then on, we caught on in the third quarter. And then, everybody was playing well at that time already. So, nahabol natin. And in the fourth quarter, medyo lumayo na tayo.
Well, for the previous World Cup qualifiers, the Philippines had two options in naturalized players, in Stan Hardinger and Pringle. Yes. The first one, you played Stan Hardinger. And then you played Pringle in Qatar.
Yes.
So what was the logic behind your kumbaga decision making in playing Stan Hardinger sa Iran and then Qatar see Stanley Pringle?
Mainly because we needed Christian Stan Hardinger for the Iran game, mainly because of his size. No, we needed the big guys. Again, as I said, we were really preparing for Haddadi, but there are other 7-footers in that team, 6'9", 6'10", who are big, bulky, and strong. No? So the coaching staff and I decided that the best person to use as the naturalized player, we only had two choices actually, no? Si Stan Hardinger lang, tsaka si Stanley Pringle. So we needed size, we went with Christian Stan Hardinger. And he played so well, no, in that game against Iran. Now, we were going to the Kazakhstan game, and we were having second thoughts. Christian played so well, and of course, I had already told Stanley before that, Christian will play Iran, and then you'll play Kazakhstan.
But Qatar?
Qatar. I'm sorry. So it's Qatar. And then, again, we had to decide, we had to make a hard decision to stick to our word.
But then in the first half, Coach Yeng, it seemed like a size issue against the Qatar game.
Yes, yes.
So we're having second thoughts, so parang, naku, bakit si Stanley yung pinasa
ko? Tama yun. Pero number one, Stanley played so well for us in the Asian Games, and he deserved a chance to play in the FIBA. So that was one issue. Also, I thought Stanley brought a lot more than Christian, but for his size, he brought a lot of things into the game. No? He played defense. He can penetrate, he can shoot the three, he's a leader, and he brings the team together, no, as a leader and as a point guard. So sabi ko, Stanley na tayo, kay Stanley na tayo. And he proved us right, actually.
All right, Coach Yeng, two questions moving forward. Your preparations against Kazakhstan and your team's expectations, more or less, how many wins do you need to get para mag-qualify na for the World Cup?
It will really depend on how Japan is playing. No, so as long as we're winning and Japan is winning, we're still okay. No? But if we're winning and Japan loses, maybe 2 wins would make it. No? Pero kung talo tayo and then Japan's winning on their windows, medyo delikado tayo. So I think we still have 4 games left. Para sigurado, we can only lose one of the 4 games. No, that's left. Para sigurado.
Yes.
If Japan loses a couple more games, baka 2 wins will suffice.
Okay, no?
So
okay.
It will really depend on the performance of Japan in their own window.
Let's say, Coach Yeng, hypothetically and hopefully, Team Pilipinas will get to qualify for the FIBA World Cup.
Yes.
Will Jordan Clarkson be able to play?
There's a really good chance that he can play. When he was in Jakarta with the national team there playing for us, he said he was ready to play as long as there was no NBA season. And the next, if we qualify for the World Cup, it will be, I think, in August. So August, medyo
summer.
Libre pa. Oh, so that's one requirement. No? Next is, of course, payagan siya ng, ano, no, ng Cleveland and NBA. But that's already been done because pinayagan na siya sa Asian Games. So I don't see any reason why di siya papayagan doon sa World Cup. I think it's even more important. No? It's even more prestigious, actually. So the next thing would be the logistics. And we've already done that in the Asian Games. So I think we can also find solutions for that.
Wishing, hoping, praying for the best for Team Pilipinas. Pero Coach Yeng, I'll give you this opportunity to thank all of your supporters na sumuporta sa inyo sa Team Pilipinas, Coach.
Yes, salamat po to all the people who supported and prayed for us. To the PBA who lent us their players. No, I think that's really the key here is for everybody to get together. The SBP who supported us all the way, Boss Butch Antonio, our manager, and Alpan Lilio, of course, Sunny Barrios, PBA Commissioner Willie Marshall, Chairman of the Board is Ricky Vargas, no? And all the PBA board members, we owe them a lot. Of course, personally, I owe Boss Raymond Yu and Terry K a huge debt of gratitude because they were the ones who originally requested that I coach the Rain or Shine Corps, which actually precipitated me coaching the window. So to all the people who prayed for us, to all the people who are wishing us well, para sa inyo po yun. Kaya po kami nagsakripisyo para sa inyo.
All right. Once again, it is an honor, Coach Yeng Guiao, for your time here on the show.
Thank you.